For a general function, it is hard to compute its Fourier transform because you need to compute a complex integral. There are a few cases, though, which are easy. We'll encounter two of them in this video. First of all, we have a block function. So a function is 1 if x is between minus 1 and 1, and 0 everywhere else. Well, you can integrate it from minus infinity to infinity. That has to be bounded, and that is the case, of course, because you can easily see what the integral from minus infinity to infinity is. It's just the area over here, which equals 2. So we can take the Fourier transform. What happens if we compute it? Well, let's try. You had of omega, so what do we need to do? Integrate from minus infinity to infinity with respect to x. Put your u of x here and multiply with e to the power minus I omega x. So what is our u of x in this case? Well, it's 0 everywhere, apart if we are between minus 1 and 1. So we integrate from minus 1 to 1, because everywhere else the product is 0 anyway. And between minus 1 and 1, u is just 1. So we are only left with this e to the power minus I omega x. Now, the problem is often to do this integration, but in this case we can do it, because we know the antiderivative of e to the power minus I omega x with respect to x. It is e to the power minus I omega x, and you have to divide by minus I omega, and then plug in the boundaries, 1 and minus 1, upper boundary, minus lower boundary. And then we observe something nice, because we see that we actually have a minus sign, and then e to the power I omega minus e to the power minus I omega, and that is exactly 2i times the sine of omega. So in the numerator over here, you have 2i times the sine of omega times the minus 1. And then we see the minus I cancels out. So we are left with 2 sine omega over omega. And there we have our Fourier transform of this first function. Let's take a look into a second example. Now we take the exponential function, exponentially decaying function for x positive and 0 for x negative. Why can't we put the exponential everywhere? Well, the exponentially decaying function for x positive goes down to 0, so that's nice, becomes very small, you can integrate it. If you would also take it for x negative, then it blows up and the integral does not exist. So, yeah, we cannot compute the Fourier transform of that one, but we can use this one, because in this case, 0 and then exponentially decaying, then your integral of u is finite. So let's compute its Fourier transform. We use the definition again. U hat of omega, integrate from minus infinity to infinity with respect to x, put your u of x here and multiply with this e to the power minus I omega x. What do we have in this case? Well, for x negative, u is 0. So we only have to integrate from 0 up to infinity. And for this positive x, the function is defined as e to the power minus x dx. So there we have our integral. Can we integrate this one? Yes, we are lucky here, because the function is not that hard. You can turn this part here into one exponent. Then you get e to the power minus I omega minus 1 times x. And now we have something of the form e to the power ax. We can find a derivative, an antiderivative of that. That is 1 over a times e to the power ax. So we get a 1 over the rubbish minus I omega minus 1, and then exponent remains the same between infinity and 0. Now the upper boundary yields 0. We'll show that on the next slide. So we are only left with the lower boundary. So we get a minus because of the lower boundary, and then a 1 over minus I omega minus 1. And cancelling out some minus signs, you find that u hat of omega equals 1 over 1 plus I omega. So you see, u is a real function and your u hat becomes a complex function. That is what happens in general. Now, this upper boundary may still be nagging you, so let's show that it indeed its contribution goes to 0. We can compute this limit using the squeeze law, because if we take the absolute value of this number over here, the absolute value, the norm of this one over here, we know that the norm of a product is product of the norms, so we get the norm of e to the power minus I omega x times the norm of e to the power minus I x. Norm of e to the power minus I omega x is just equal to 1, So we're left with e to the power minus ix. Now what happens if you send x to infinity, then this will yield 0. So that means that we can squeeze this norm over here between 0 and 0, which means that the limit x to infinity of what is squeezed in between equals 0. So the limit of a norm of a complex number is 0, then the limit of the complex number itself equals 0. And that's why the upper boundary drops out. And that is why we have, in the end, our u hat of omega equals 1 over 1 plus I omega.